going on, everybody, man? It's Alfred LaButler. Got my partner in crime with me, Professor X.
What's up, everybody?
You already know what time it is, man. Unspoken culture. Let's get it.
Let's get it.
Let's get to exactly, you know what I'm saying, the Jaguars training camp, man.
Yes, sir.
You know, Professor X already went there first. You know, my time is Wednesday. I'm going Wednesday. He's already been there. So, what's your thoughts, man? What's your expectations from last year, you know, up 10 in Foxborough against the Patriots, man, you know, 12 minutes away from the Super Bowl to now? What's your take on it with the additions? How you feeling?
Well, I feel pretty good just from watching the first practice. I went out to the practice on last Wednesday, and I believe it was the second practice at that point. And then they had their not Wednesday, it was on Friday. Then Saturday they had their first full padded practice. Now I heard that practice didn't go too well. I heard they were kind of, you know, playing a little lazy and things like that. And the practice I went to, you know, Bortles threw a pick six, but it wasn't a bad ball. The offense looked good. You know, Bortles had a lot of deep plays, like the Marquise. Dante Moncrief limped off the field, but he still, before that, he was looking really good, and I heard that he even practiced the next day. So, I mean, just from where we were last season, you know, it's obviously going to be another long road trying to get back to where we were last year. It's not going to be easier. It's going to be that much harder. And, you know, this is a critical time in the, you know, in our season or off season, because right out the gate, you know, we're going to play the New York Giants. You know, at Giants, they were 3-13 last year, but we all know they have talent on the team. You know, they're a better team. They're going to be better coached. And, you know, Eli Manning's not, you know, he's got something to prove a little bit. So that's not going to just be just a gimme game. You know, you can't base that game off of last year's results. So we got that, and then we got New England, and then we play Tennessee. So we can easily start the season off 0-3 if we're not, you know,
careful.
If we're not careful. So,
well, like, it's very critical, man. You know, my take, man, I'm real, you know, as a Jaguar fan, I'm real pessimistic.
Yeah.
You know, I'm always.
I feel you, man.
I'm looking at the glass half empty than full. So, I always got stats. You know, I always put it out. So since 1989 to 2016, there's been 23 teams that have improved their win total by 7 games.
I saw that.
Now, the same Jaguars, they were 13-3. They jumped to 10-6 last year. Only three teams out of the 23. The 97 Jets, 2012 Colts, 2014 Texans matched or improved that record. Now, Blake Bortles, man, it's no reason why I don't think he'll come out guns blazing. I mean, if you think about it, last year he had a QBR 55.6, which is higher than Kirk Cousins, who just got signed in Minnesota, and Cam Newton, MVP of two seasons ago. So, man, with that newfound confidence, man, from last year, I don't see why he wouldn't be coming out. You know, man, we added Dante Moncrief. You know, he was the number one option in Indy that really didn't pan out too much.
I won't say number one, because T.Y. Hill was still still doing his thing.
He has number one talent.
And then we got also Tavarian Jenkins, so that's another target. Yeah. He looks really good in camp too.
Okay.
He looks good,
Now, of course, we got returning receivers, Marquise Lee, you know, Keelan Cole. My bold prediction, I think out of all the receivers, I think D.D. Westbrook. He'll be the breakout. I think he'll be the one. He'll be the 1,000-yard receiver. Okay. Of course, during the offseason, man, we got Andrew Norwell, All-Pro guard.
I heard he was terrible.
Really?
So far,
Yeah, well, you know,
he's still getting acclimated.
Yeah, definitely helped Fournette. I think maintaining the balance in the run game, relieving pressure off Bortles. But although I expect their offense to dramatically increase, I think the defense will take a step back.
I won't think they'll take a step back. I think our defense will be just as good, but I think we're going to win games with our offense this year.
Well, listen, I think Jaguar defense was historically great, and I wouldn't be speaking hyperbole if I compared them to the Ravens of 2000, the 85 Bears, the Seahawks. They're up there. Now, although we got talent and, you know, we actually drafted, you know, more depth, it comes down to health, man. I mean, once again, another stat, man, out of 11 starters, 11 plus our key backups, which is Alvin Coleman and Dante Fowler.
Nobody missed
combined
the game.
Right? Only three games.
Oh, three, that's right.
Only three.
Because Kelvin
ain't no way they're gonna be able to
repeat that. Together,
so. Ain't no way they're gonna be able to repeat that. So I think just health and nutrition alone is gonna prevent them from really, really. And then, you know, the Jaguars franchise too, man. They banking on it because they cap, man. They spent $120 million.
Yeah, on the defense. Yeah, we got
defense. So. No team in the NFL, the other 31 teams, man, has even over $100 million on their defense in the cap. So, I mean, they know where their bread and butter is, you know? So,
I mean, when you think about it, though, and the stat I saw too was they had this projected to win, what, like 11.89 wins, so about 12 wins. And I can see that happening. I mean, if you look at it, if our defense plays at the same level, you know, even given some injuries, that's why I like the fact that we addressed. I didn't like it when we drafted Taven Bryan, but now you look at it, you know, if somebody goes down on the D-line, we got him, you know. If somebody goes down in the secondary, you still got Ronnie Harrison, and he could even play up and play linebacker if one of our linebackers go down. He can kind of hybrid that position. And then I do like Tyler Patman as a fourth-string cornerback. You know, I don't know too much about DJ Hayden yet. He looked pretty good in camp so far.
I think the defense.
I just think if anybody goes down on defense, I think we still.
I think legit. We're loaded except the linebacker position because.
Yeah, linebacker is obviously the weakest. Yeah, but.